Alright everybody, day two of Brush Hogging. To bring everybody up to speed who's new, this is the field that I have that I'm working towards on haying, which you can see it needs some work. I'm hoping keeping stuff brush hogged down and get this stuff going towards the weeds, the mold grub, stuff like that. The field that you saw me brush hog on day one over there, I did not do last year, except for the last time, when I did this at the end of last year, the person that owns this property had me mow up by where there's a hunting stand to kind of open it up for a friend of mine who hunts over here. The owner of the property is an over-the-road truck driver. He's gone like 2 weeks and then home for so many days or weeks or however his schedule works. And he wants us to be kept mowed. And last year he offered if I can pay him or anything like that, that I could. So that's what I'm working towards. Kind of see a little bit of where I was brush hogging yesterday, which I'll show more of that the next time I'm up here, because I do not think I'm going to get this whole entire field in today. I just do it a little bit after work. I won't be up here tomorrow because we're going to go look at a house. But hopefully Friday. I did get that side all done on Sunday. So, a couple projects coming up. The loader 656 has some work to be done. And that's going to be one too. But I'll cover that in a second. The loader 656. I gotta pull the gas tank off of that because a friend of mine came and power washed it for me because I wanted to get it cleaned up before the cab went on. Only discovered that the gas tank had discovered two very small pinholes on the bottom. Not right by the sediment bowl, but pretty close. So, before the cab goes on, I'm going to pull the gas tank off and take that to my mechanic, and he's going to take it to a place called Custom Rebuilders, where they will clean it, seal it, and reline it. I don't know necessarily what order they do, but and then going to do that because once the cab's on, it's going to be quite a pain to get that done. I have it patched, so to speak, but it's like a JB Weld type deal on the bottom. It's holding fairly well, but I want to get it done properly, just so I can do a few things before I do pull the gas tank off of it. And then hopefully then it won't be much longer. It'll get a space off enough to get the cab on. From the cabin I just showed you back there, belonged to the property owner's dad when he was alive, and it's not that it's not structurally sound, in fact that it is, but the mice have kind of taken over, so you kind of get an idea as far as that goes. Now, it's got a lot of rough cut 2x4s and stuff like that, but they're all in really, really good shape. That I will utilize for our cabin, that me and a few other of my family members own, that is actually in another video, and will be in other ones, to help with the upkeep for that one, as our cabin actually is much older. It was built in 1932 or 34, I can't remember which one, off the top of my head, I believe it's 34. Anywho, there's stuff in there that he's keeping, and I know what that is, and once he gets his stuff out, everything left over is free game. So if that at all interests anybody, I will do videos of that as I work on it. So, as far as that goes, that's pretty much it for projects. The Massey Ferguson, again, did find a new home, and the reason for that is my cousin's husband and my cousin bought their first house, and he actually has subscribed to my channel, so you guys got a great place. It was awesome visiting with you over the weekend. But a couple weeks ago, we were up at our cabin, and he was asking me about tractors. He wants to do kind of a homesteading type deal. And I kind of tossed around a couple ideas, like in particular the 4000 series. But then I remembered I had the Massey Ferguson, which, don't get me wrong, I like the tractor. It is a very good tractor. But I kind of leaned more towards something with a little more ground clearance. I'd really like to find either a Farmall 300, 400, 50 series of this tool, or even a 4 or 560. Anywho, that I will kind of enjoy more, I think. And also with that, to kind of help them get started, I sent the two bottom plows, which I technically don't need because I have those three bottoms now, and those drag discs, which I haven't shown yet, but they're on the other side of that cabin, up on it a little bit, which you guys will see when I load them on the trailer and take them out there, because I'm going to get another set of pull behinds like what I had before, just in better shape. And then I went with the back blade that I had with it because that's too small for any of the trackers I have now. And then a couple of things, but he's really happy with it, and I'm glad it's going to work well for him. So he's already kind of got bit the bug, I guess you could say. He's ordered manuals, he's got filters for it, so I'm glad he's happy with it. So if you guys have any advice for him, leave them in comments, because like I said, he did subscribe. And also, welcome any new subscribers. I hope you guys enjoy my content. Please feel free to comment. Leave suggestions if you have any. And hopefully I keep you guys around for a while. Now, I'm not going to video the whole time I'm here. I'm just getting you guys back up to speed, and if I'm back up Friday, I'll take a video of what's done in this field, and I'll show you how that field looks up there, because as you see the first one, I'm pretty sure you're watching this one too, it'll look a lot better. So, anywho, I think that's going to do it for this video today. Day 2 of brush hogging. I was going to come yesterday, but we got a really bad storm that came through, knocked power out at the end of the shift, so that wasn't happening. And Monday I had to drop my truck off at the body shop, because we got a little bit of storm damage a few weeks ago, so that's been taken care of. Aside from that, guys, that's going to do it for today, so I will catch you guys hopefully Friday.